During the BruCON conference 2016, I participated in the local CTF, where I won 3rd place. Because it was a CTF for individuals, the difficulty was not high, so I was able to solve many challenges alone. I didn't record all challenges, but let's have a look at some of them. I start with the easy challenge, which I really didn't like. The description says that we have to identify unusual traffic in this packet capture and count them. The flag will be the SHA-256 hash of that number. So let's download and open that capture. While doing that, I try to think, what could unusual packet mean? That is not really clear. It highly depends on the context of this network. Let's say I have a capture traffic from a phone. It could be weird to see SSH traffic. But when I have a capture from a computer, that would be normal. Are unusual packets maybe corrupted ones? Or are packets out of order? The hint also says that those packets were sent by the source, so I try to figure out what the heck they mean. I start with some filters for what I think is the source IP and start looking for packets that are not typical packets on port 8443353 for DNS. At this point, I give up on the challenge and move on to something else. I wasted so much time not knowing what to look for. This is very frustrating because the challenge description is just not clear to me. It feels more like guessing rather than showing knowledge or skill. I feel like the challenge should have required more information, a story what exactly we are expected to find in there. Anyhow, I will later get the flag, but on another way. But first, let's move on to another challenge. I don't like these forensic challenges a lot, so I was very happy to see a reversing challenge, reverse beer. Apparently also pretty easy, find the key. But the flag is not in a standard format. First criticism here, can you please tell me what format the flag will have? Because if you don't provide a flag format, I might have to start guessing and that can be frustrating. But let's see. So I download the file and check the file format. Looks like a 32-bit Linux binary, that sounds great. So I continue and open the binary in Binary Ninja and in parallel I try to run the binary on a Linux system. So here I have a 64-bit Linux machine on DigitalOcean, but I can't execute the binary. I was a bit puzzled by that, but then I remembered I didn't install the 32-bit libraries. While they are installing, I have a first look at the assembler code. So when I follow main, I immediately notice a function call to ptrace, and afterwards a jump not equal. So that is a simple anti-debugging check that can be simply bypassed by always jumping to the code that continues. You can save the binary and continue to work with that one on the Linux machine in case you want to debug it. But let's continue here. Next we notice a call string to unsigned long, which will convert a string to a number. Afterwards we see these suspiciously similar blocks in a row. That looks very interesting. But first I want to run the program and see what it does. Okay, so we have to provide a number as parameter. I didn't immediately go for the interesting blocks because I felt I didn't understand the binary yet and wanted to get a better overview before chasing something down. So for example this f function, which seems to print something. And there are also these huge ASCII art pictures that have a symbol name but in a different language. So I translated those. Now I understand better what I tried to get to. I don't want this bad ASCII output, I want this good output. So now I look at the blocks in a row and see the compares, which probably check the number we enter. Each block takes the input number, extracts a byte from it with masking and shifting, and then comparing it. So the first block doesn't shift, so that's the lowest byte. The third block shifts by 8 bit, so 1 byte, and uses test EAX EAX, which means it's checking if the second byte is 0. Then comes the second block, which verifies the third byte to be 6B. And the last block checks the last byte with B1. Okay, now we have the correct number, which we can use as a key. And it works. We have a different output, and it tells us that the key we found is the flag. By the way, it's not BruCON's fault because the CTF was organized by a third party, but stupid sexual jokes like that drive some women out of the field. Not cool. Okay, so despite the flag format not being clear at first, the challenge was telling you exactly what the flag is. Though, in my opinion, this information that the input key is the flag could have been already disclosed in the description and would have been completely unambiguous. Next up, virtual lockpicking for 350. I have no idea why this challenge is worth 350 points and what exactly it is supposed to teach you. or what kind of skill is required, but here's how I did it. So I follow the provide link and find this weird game website. Looks like a small flash game or something where you have to lockpick. I immediately notice the draft tag and the create and see inside button, which sounds like this website is actually for developing games, and you can look into the code. So I look inside and get presented these logical code blocks. You can drag and drop these blocks and create a program that way. So I'm just clicking around and try to see if something looks like logic that hides the flag or whatever. And eventually I find this weird lonely block with a base64 string. At this moment it was clear that I got the solution. Behind it is a URL to an image which contains the flag. Very easy, didn't require any hacking skills. Worth more than reversing a Linux binary. Oh, and before I forget it, here is how I solved the first challenge. I just wrote a simple Python script that brute forces the flag. I use a for loop to count up the number of packets, hash a number with SHA-256, and send the request to the CTF page. And eventually my script stopped because it found the correct flag. So I was gaming the game. Still no idea what the unusual packets are, but as a hacker you sometimes have to think around the corner.